Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with a Dell PowerEdge R760xs rack server. With the XS on the name, I was expecting a little extra or XS compared to the standard R760, but that is not the case. There are some pretty significant differences between this system and the R760. Specifically, the R760xs supports a few less cores on the processors, less memory, slightly different storage options, and less storage in general. It also consumes less power when compared to the R760, which is a definite plus. If you like our videos, hit that subscribe button. It does help our channel. Let's get to it. With the differences I mentioned, the R760xs is designed to lower costs and increase your ROI in comparison to the R760, not to mention providing a platform that is more targeted at specific workloads. Dell's PowerEdge R760xs provides flexible storage and offers scalable performance. It can be used to support VDI, or virtual desktop infrastructure, virtual machines, and used as a software-defined storage node. With an option for no drives up front, or in back for that matter, this system can be used purely to provide additional compute with a few GPUs installed, or as a host system for SAN or NAS applications. In contrast, the R760 is perhaps a little more flexible and seeks to address some high-performance workloads with support for more cores and double-wide GPUs. Workloads like AI and machine learning, but can also be used to do the same things as the R760xs. You can see that video here. This is not to spend more of your IT budget than absolutely necessary. It's kind of like when Goldilocks samples the three bears porridge. One was too hot, one was too cold, but that last one, just right. There are a few other R760 platforms with different end suffix, like the R760XA and the R760XD2. Again, designed to provide maximum performance for the supported workload. The R760XA is specifically designed for artificial intelligence and machine learning, analytics, visualization, and performance rendering applications. Using NVIDIA NVLink technology, it offers support for up to 4 double-wide Gen 5 high-performance GPUs, or up to 12 single-wide GPU accelerators, or 10 single-wide if you go with the all-PCI-by-16 slot riser instead of the by-8 version. The R760XD2, on the other hand, is for storage-intensive applications like video capture and retrieval, object storage, and content delivery networks. The R760XD2 can support up to 28 3.5-inch front and mid-tray SAS SATA drives, plus up to 4 NVMe rear drive cage for a storage capacity of up to 616 terabytes. It also offers reduced latency with up to 2 75-watt NVIDIA GPU accelerators and those NVMe drives, including E3.S form factors, and back to the R760XS. Have some flexible storage or scalable performance workloads to address? Perhaps the Dell PowerEdge R760XS is in your future. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at itcreations.com that's valued at $5,000 or more. Click that link for more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Goldilocks would be so proud of you. I think even the bears too, once they're done with their Charmin toilet paper contract. A front-mounted bezel is optional and comes with either an LCD or security option. I think they look quite nice too, like an AI beehive just waiting to hatch and decimate humanity. I've been watching way too many Netflix movies, like the really low ratings ones. On the front of the system, there are still a number of different storage options depending on your workload. At maximum, you can have up to 24 2.5-inch drives with a combination of 16 SAS SATA drives plus 8 NVMe HDDs or SSDs. Also, a 12-bay 3.5-inch drive chassis that can also support 2.5-inch SAS SATA or NVMe drive formats. At the other end of the storage scale, 8-bay 3.5-inch and 2.5-inch options with a 16-bay 2.5-inch drive bay option in between. You will need a PowerEdge RAID controller or PERC for SAS drive support. There are various PERC 11 and latest PERC 12 offerings for that. Some PERCs can also support NVMe RAID 2. The integrated S160 offers software RAID for NVMe or SATA drives and is compatible with Windows operating systems. Oh, and also the zero bay option, also called the no backplane configuration like we have on our system. No PERC required. It seems very rare that we actually get one that's loaded with all the goodies, and there was no Goldilocks scenario in this instance. The left control panel has status LEDs, a system health and system ID indicator, and an iDRAC QuickSync 2 wireless indicator. I will mention the QuickSync 2 wireless indicator is only available on certain configurations. The status LEDs include a drive indicator, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCI indicator. The right server ear has power on button, USB port, iDirect direct micro port, iDirect direct status LED, plus a VGA port to connect a monitor or laptop to the system. The back of the R760xs server is a little different from that of the R760. PSUs are stacked on the far left-hand side, not one to either side like on the R760, with 2800 watt PSUs supported. In fact, there are several variations for all of these different R760 platforms, but I will try to concentrate on just this one for the sake of clarity. This one, the R760xs, only supports up to 1800 watts of juice, including a few lower wattage options. The PSU is also a new form factor for these 16th gen platforms at 60 millimeter. No, those 15th gen PSUs will not work on this system. Just above those PSUs is where the optional 2 2.5-inch drive bay cage would be located, and next to that, the optional boot optimized storage subsystem, or BOS, that can be used to support the OS or hypervisor in mirror mode with two M.2 drives installed. You can also get this module with only a single drive. The BOS supports RAIDs of 0 and 1. Then a system identification button, VGA port, OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot, a USB 3.0 port, and a USB 2.0 port. The dedicated iDirect Gigabit Ethernet port and dual Gigabit Ethernet LAN ports. Dell offers the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, or iDirect, to manage your server remotely or at chassis using the Quick Sync feature for an Android or iOS-based smartphone or tablet with the OpenManage mobile app. Or you can connect using the iDirect Direct port on the right side of the system by hooking up a crash card. You can also access iDirect from a standard browser once you connect the system to your network using that dedicated Gigabit Ethernet LAN RJ45 port on the back, specifically used to manage the system. We made a short video on iDirect 9 Enterprise, which you can see here. If you need to cover more than just the single chassis, Dell offers the OpenManage system for one-to-many servers or large clusters. The system is also compatible with other third-party management options. As an air-cooled server, there are three different fan configurations for this system. They include standard fans, high-performance fans in either silver or gold. Also standard and high-performance heat sinks, depending on the configuration. If installing GPUs, then you will need high-performance heat sinks for CPUs with a thermal design power rating or TDP greater than 185 watts. You'll also need those high-performance heat sinks with storage configurations with 12 3.5-inch storage bays, and if you add the rear storage module to this configuration. The R760xs, like the storage-intensive R760 XD2, can be outfitted with one or two fourth-generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs with up to 32 cores per socket. Yes, cores have been limited on the system compared to the R760 and R760XA, which can go as high as 56 cores per socket. Memory has also been cut back to 16 memory module slots, which is one of the cost-saving features, as less memory module slots means less cost to produce the motherboard. At capacity, the system will accept up to 1 terabyte of ECC DDR5 registered memory modules, operating at up to 4,800 megatransfers per second. Yes, memory has been curtailed a bit too. Perhaps in a few months, they may increase the memory support, but don't count on it. I mean, Intel seems to be churning out new processors all the time now. Apparently, 5th-gen Emerald Rapids CPUs are compatible with the 4th-gen Sapphire Rapids socket and motherboard. So only Dell knows how long this is going to play out in the months ahead. Most likely, Dell will just upgrade to the R770 or R780 or something like that. With both processors installed, the platform can support up to 6 PCIe slots, 2 PCIe Gen 5x16 slots, 3 PCIe 4.0x16 slots, and a single x8 Gen 4 slot. If you only install a single CPU, then only up to 4 PCIe slots are active. An OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot can also provide additional I/O along with integrated dual 1 gigabit Ethernet LAN ports. The 4th generation CPUs also are compatible with the CXL 1.1 for next-gen workloads. CXL 1.1 uses the standard PCIe physical layer, in other words, the PCIe slots. It's designed to revolutionize the data center with a better memory interaction between CPUs and accelerators. I suppose we'll see how that works out quite soon. PCIe slots 3, 4, and 6 will accept the NVIDIA A2 GPU, but only 2 GPUs, so choose wisely. The A2 is the only GPU I saw listed for this system. But at 75 watts in a single-width, low-profile slot, the tried-and-true NVIDIA T4 GPU can be squeezed in there too. The NVIDIA A2 features Ampere architecture and 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory, also 1,280 shading units, 40 texture mapping units, 32 render output units, or ROPs, plus 40 tensor cores. At a 60-watt power draw, you don't need any additional power cables, and it will draw power off of the PCIe slot. It uses a PCIe 4.0x8 interface and features 40 tensor cores. In comparison, the T4 has 320 tensor cores, but a few generations removed from the Turing architecture. But it too has 16 gigabytes of memory, but consumes a bit more power at up to 70 watts. The A2 is an entry-level card for inference acceleration and for edge deployments, offering 20 times more inference performance than a CPU-only server. The T4, on the other hand, is good for machine learning, deep learning, and distributed computing environments. Certainly, there is more to discuss about the Dell PowerEdge R760xs server with all the different configuration options, but I know you have lives to live, so I'll just keep it short. Check out IT Creations if you want to learn more. I placed a few links in the description below, and you can also check out the other variations of the R760 chassis at the same time. There's also a link to this system at IT Creations right there. If you like this video, give it the thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel. There is definitely more to come, not to mention those platforms supporting the fifth generation CPUs from both AMD and Intel. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.